If Gogebic Taconite gets the green light to open an iron ore mine in northern Wisconsin and create thousands of jobs, the company says it plans on training workers from the area with no previous mining experience.
The history of this company is that they hire workers locally and that they like to train their own workers. They don't like to have workers with previous mining experience because they like to do the training and take responsibility for that themselves. I would also add that to Representative Williams' question about what we expect from state and local government. One thing we don't expect is job training. The company provides that.
After this lengthy explanation, Representative Jocasta Zamarripa demanded to know why the company would not have to pay for government-administered job training programs.
Do you know why the funding for job training that was included in last year's version of the bill that you testified on, do you know why it was deleted in this new Assembly Bill 1?
Although her question had already been answered, representatives from the company answered it again, but from a different perspective.
It would have set a new precedent in Wisconsin that a company trying to come and bring jobs and investment to the state would have been taxed on a product that was years away from actually being produced and sold. And the idea that Wisconsin would set a precedent that would go around the nation to other employers across the country, not just in mining, but that Wisconsin is willing to increase it, to put a new tax on a company before it ever even had the chance to produce a product in the state, I would feel is a dangerous precedent, and it does work against the idea of this $1.5 billion investment or many other investments in many other industries coming to Wisconsin.
In general, Democrats are critical of the mining bill and want language that requires mining companies to hire mostly Wisconsin workers. For the McIver Institute, I'm Bill Osmolsky.